Hello and welcome to the show. I am back today on Planet Coaster, going to be trying to build the best go-kart track in the world. You see, the latest update for this game has brought a whole bunch of new stuff, and one of them is go-kart tracks. And anyone that's played the old Roller Coaster Tycoon games will know that the best possible fun you can have is building go-kart tracks. And now, yeah, thankfully Planet Coaster has given us that fun. You can also build racing roller coasters. You can now sync up the sort of start platforms for two roller coasters so that they can go racing against each other, which is fantastic as well. I might have to give that a try. It's very difficult, but I might have to have a go at that at some point. Anyway, yeah, we're gonna build a go-kart track. I figured I would use this is a park I've worked on actually quite a lot. This is perhaps the most detailed park. I kind of had an idea of doing little islands around, kind of have one roller coaster per island and maybe dot in some other things. And I thought this would be a fun enough park to build a go-kart track. Not really in keeping with the theme. As you can see, we've kind of all got like piratey bits. This is my little pirate fort going on here. not really in keeping with the theme. However, it's a pretty park over this corner, so we'll have that in the background for our go-kart track rather than just sort of starting afresh. Oh, I've managed to cock up with the... How have I done that? When did I do that? I don't know. We've got a little stairway going on in the corner. Sure. Anyway, let us get out of this lovely cinematic mode. There's apparently been a theft. That's another thing. I don't know when that got added. I don't think that's in the most recent of updates, but yeah, there's now crime and so on. I've got some security guards wandering around. Hopefully they can do something about it. Anyway, we are going to go and get the go-karts. Now, I believe there's some of this stuff in here is, I think, slightly newer, slightly different as well. I don't know. Perhaps not. Maybe they've had all of this stuff in here before. I can't remember. I think the River Rapids are relatively new. I don't remember them anyway. Anyway, go-kart time. Now, I think for this, we're going to use this corner over here. This is going to be our little go-kart area. Now, I'm not going to build the island first. I'm going to build the go-kart track and then put the island kind of around it. I'm not really sure what I want to do with the go-kart track yet, and the go-kart track is the important part, not the scenery. So we're going to mess about with the track first, and then we are going to worry about... I'm probably not going to get to the point of doing the scenery in this video, but if we do come back to it, if people really want to see me come back to it and so on, then yeah, maybe we will. So, this is our go-kart. As far as sort of special parts go, we can have a narrowing bit, and we can have a full-on chicane area. Now, we don't want to go straight from a start line into a narrow bit. That's just called asking for a crash. Likewise, start line and straight into a chicane, also asking for a crash. We could do the Oschersleben thing and have start line into horrendous, horrendously nasty turn one. That is also asking for a crash. We're probably not going to do that either. We are going to... How big a thing do we want? The moment we've got angle snap on, I might turn that off, possibly. How long are sections do we want to build this in? Shall we go for 10-meter sections, I think? Now, for a first corner, we want a fairly decent size straight. Of course, your best overtaking opportunities. I don't know how the AI acts, by the way. I should point this out. I'm building this with, you know, normal racing track building mind on, and I don't know how the AIs behave on go-kart tracks. But I'm going to try and build this like a good racetrack, and we'll see if the AIs actually, you know, overtake, have battles. I'm not really expecting them to. Be really cool if they did, but we're not expecting them to. Anyway, we want a relatively decent long straight and then a relatively tight corner, because of course most of your overtaking is going to happen under braking. Admittedly, in go-karts you're not going to be having a huge amount of braking. However, we're not quite going to have a full-on hairpin. We're not quite going to go for sort of full-on ridiculously tight corner, but we're going to have this sort of a corner. We're going to have like a nice widening radius corner, so you could really get the power down nice and early, I would hope, through this turn one. It'll give us some overtaking opportunities. We can, of course, play around with elevations. Now, unfortunately, we can't go for sort of Laguna Seca-esque corkscrew, or we can't go for kind of Radeon and Eau Rouge, that style corner, because we can only do 12 degrees, which isn't exactly a huge amount. But we might be able to get some interesting things going on out of here. So if we then... Now, see, I'm a real fan for really high-speed corners. I like really high-speed corners. So we're going to go for sort of a nice little high-speed S-bend through here. The go-karts are probably going to be very, very easily flat out. Actually, what we'll do is if we loop this around like so, and then we can have a crossover point. Now, because we're playing around with go-karts, if actually what we could do is, bugger it, why not? We'll go for a crossover point over the start line. We're playing around with go-karts, so we can get away with this sort of a thing, and then we'll come back down the other side. Now, we were keeping it at that level. We were keeping it slightly off the water, so when I come to build around the place... We have a little bit of leeway going on. Right, so then we're going to go into a nice little tight corner around here. Not quite going back on itself just yet. And then we're going to go, should we go for some chicanes down the back straight? Sure, we'll have a middle chicane section. No, we don't want to go for too long with chicanes. We'll just have a New York-esque chicane, kind of. I mean, New York chicanes are always nastier buggers than this one. Much nastier, however. That'll do. Now, we're going to want to bring the... One of my big roller coasters over there. The one on the actual built-up island. That's broken down. Mechanic, someone go and fix that. Alright, so far we've got a decent turn one. Pleased with turn one. Then we have this... kind of starts off as a high-speed S section. Actually, it'd be a really nasty corner because you go into it quite fast. And then you've got to get it... You kind of got to... Yeah, that's a really nasty bug. I've designed a really horrible corner because you want to be, of course, breaking in a straight line. As I said, again, not that there's going to be a huge amount of braking, but you'd want to be braking in a straight line vaguely down there. But because you're kind of turning through the first part of the S-bend, you've kind of got to straighten the first part up, then get it slowed, then get it turned, climb over this crest. I wonder if we can... I don't think it'll let me put, like, chicanes up hills and so on. Not that we necessarily want to, but, yeah, we've got that sort of thing over there. We've got another tight corner down here into a chicane section. Shall we go out of the chicane section into a narrow section? Can we do narrow section corners? Yes, indeed we can. Shall we be really mean and make it really narrow and then really technical? We can go full meanness right here. Narrow, again, having a slightly opening radius corner. We're going to have to... climb back up, I think. Ooh, I wonder if we can climb back up. We can climb back up. This could be quite an interesting... We could have quite an interesting little, like, downhill section somewhere as we come up. We'll again go to a wide circuit. So that will cover the start-finish line. So we're now clear of the start-finish line. Shall we go for a downhill... kind of spiral it downhill. Maybe we want to go a little bit further forward first. I'm just trying to get keeping away from the start-finish line because I don't really want to interrupt that. If we were to then go spiral down this way, there we go. That'd be quite good fun. You don't normally see that on racetracks. However, I think perhaps we should. Perhaps we should have more racetracks. That's our equivalent of the corkscrew because that is actually really steep on the inside. That's really steep on the inside. Yes, I like it. I didn't think we'd be able to get away with sort of crazy elevation changes, but that is... it's got to have a cool name, so I think that shall be the Helix. That is what that corner shall be. That is the best possible thing we can do with that corner. Then we will... What else do we want? Now, we could loop the track back around. So from here, we could loop it back around left and back to the start-finish line. Or we could head off in another direction. How are we doing? Track design-wise, it kind of looks like something out of Need for Speed Underground, quite frankly. I'm okay with that. There's no problems at all with being inspired by Need for Speed Underground. Not that it was inspired, but looking like it was. If we then have a corner, we're just kind of loop ourselves around this way a little bit. Have a nice wide corner over here to make the most of, and then if we kind of scoot our way back along behind the Helix, let's have another chicane section. So there's like going on at all points around here, so we don't have any boring parts of road. I guess the only really boring part is the bridge, but then there might be the small potential for go-karts to get airborne. I don't know if they can. Fantastic if they could, but I don't think they can. We're going to have to start looping ourselves, I think, back towards the start-finish line here, so shall we get a really tight corner in here, and then we might be able to be really mean. Yep, be really mean to the drivers. I like being really mean to the drivers. Kind of loop it back this way again. I haven't really thought about how I'm going to get a path over here. Again, as far as this goes in terms of keeping with a theme, it's not great. However, it does look the part, and that's the most important bit. And then we will just go and finish it up there. Oh, we're a slightly lower height above the water Not that it matters, really. I think we can get away with that. There's a little bit of a hill led up towards... Ah, good. Well done, mechanics. You've gone and fixed that. We just got people... There's been theft. No one's really doing a very good job of dealing... The security guards I've hired are apparently crap. Then that will be the course, by the looks of it. Optional railing? Oh, we can put a railing on the actual course bits. That's cool. Right, so then is that the course done? Think it is. Now, does it say excitement rating is 6.5? That's not too bad. Actually, that's pretty good. What have we got on the sort of right? So the excitement rating on the victory over here, swinging ship, is 2. How about our big roller coaster over here? Where is it? Never mind. Yeah, so that's the same as the beached Englishman over here. 6.4 on that roller coaster, and it is a 6.5. So it's higher, in fact. This go-kart track is higher the rated excitement than this roller coaster. I'm cool with that. I'm very cool with that. Yeah, I mean, it's an interesting technical challenge, I think, in some ways. You've got a relatively normal circuit to start with, and then it sort of gets arsey later on. And I'm perfectly fine with that. Now, what we're going to do is we are going to have to get an entrance, get an exit. Can we put an exit in there? We could, but would we want to? That's probably the bigger question. I don't think where paths can go. No, we'll stick an exit over there. For now, we want to get... It has been quite some time, paths are over here, since I have built anything on this game. We're going to bring a path off of here, I think. We're going to have to bring a path. Which pathway? Is it that path? I think it is that path, actually. Is this the one we use for the long-distance walks? Sure. We'll bring a path off over in this direction. We'll try and bring it round. It's not exactly the widest of paths, but that's okay. Is that going to bring it alongside the... Okay, yeah, this can kind of skirt the track. I'm cool with that. Oops, that's not quite at the angle we wanted. Oh, I might have built the go-karts on the wonk slightly. Let's take the angle snap off there and then just kind of fit that into there. And we can angle snap it again, and that can come to a rest over here. Now, this path will probably, possibly quite easily get changed, as it is only temporary, and I don't have the kind of island essentially for it. So let's go and then bring this out a little bit. We'll just bring this out. We'll just go straight across for now. That can sit up there. Go, and then we can go back to this path for the exit. I don't know why I've got this as the maximum length for stuff, but it doesn't really matter at the moment. Right, so let's open the go-karts. We'll have to think of a clever name for them. And then we will wait. We don't have to wait. Oopsie, don't have to press that button. 3 doesn't control the speed. That controls the speed. Somebody! We've got an exciting go-kart track. Somebody come and race on it. Oh no, we'll take a little bit of time. Oh, look at the tentacles dance over there. They are correctly timed for the roller coaster, by the way. It does actually work so that as one of the carts go past, they should sort of appear and attack it. It just about works. Just about works in sequence. Right. People are making their way across towards our go-kart track. He's going to go on his own at the front there. Can we still burst people's... I seem to remember bursting people's... I might have even talked about this before. Bursting people's balloons and make them go rebuy them on old Roller Coaster Tycoon games. I don't think it lets you do that on here. It can't be a cheeky sod. Right. I'm really hoping that the AI will be half decent and that they'll actually have some exciting racing. I'm not expecting it. It's just one of those things that I would love to see in a game like this. Wait, is it? Oh, speed up the time. Right, so we've got guy in go-kart 1. Actually, how many laps do they do? I can probably tell. I can probably determine it. Yeah, like I say, they've got 2 laps of racing. I mean, that's to be expected, about right when you go to a theme park and they have go-karts around. You don't get very long. You don't get very long at all. We can customize all of that sort of bits and pieces. I don't think there's anything particularly special that we... I mean, we could add scenery triggers if we wanted to, but I don't think there's anything massively spectacular that we could do. Oh, we've got 2 more go-karts. Okay, they're going because there's no group of people. Well, everyone is very neatly lined up on the start line. Are we going to see any jump starts here? No, we are not. It is clean getaway from everybody. Red cart is going for the long way round, that first corner. There's a little bit of head bumping going on as they get on the brakes. I don't know if they could ever fall. I'm assuming they never crash. They never fall off the road. I mean, you might want to... Admittedly, when you're on such, above water, might want to get some railings around, but never mind. That is some terrible racing lines, guys. Where are you going, man? In fact, they don't even need to go, oh, there's an overtake. There has been an overtake. There has been an overtake through the chicane. That is some great driving. In fact, that green cart is going terribly slow. How do they manage the helix? I think he's going for another overtake down the inside. You are brave, good sir, because that is a hell of a drop down there. You don't really need to weave through the chicanes because you can just go straight through them. Come on, is there going to be a pass for the lead? There might be. It is neck and neck down the start-finish line. Nope, the blue cart has not got the straight-line speed at all. Well, he's either that or he's just a moron and let off. I'd imagine they're all identical carts, but never mind. I think it was this blue cart here we can't actually follow the cart individually. Try to. The blue cart. Oh, someone's had a big spin. Oh, well recovered indeed there, good sir. Well recovered indeed, but that has caused you a lot of grief. Oh, there's been a change for the lead as well. I got distracted by a crash. There's a change for the lead. The blue team is doing very, very well indeed up here. The yellow team, not so much. Probably Renault's. Oh, there's another spinner. Second place has gone round. Can there be a 1-2 for the blue team? Oh, no, there's been a crash. Oh, there's some cheeky tactics going on from red team there. They're blocking it. It's not going to matter, though, because the blue cart's going to go around the outside regardless. He has got the position. Our original leader has dropped down to third place. Victory is going to go to the blue cart over there. And it's going to be a 1-2 for the blue. Maybe not, because they're now all cruising in to stop. I think blue took victory regardless. Was he a lap? I don't know. Slightly confused by him. I'm pretty sure he was the leader. Either way, a blue cart won. The yellow carts didn't do very well. We saw a couple of big spin-outs. Nobody crashed into a tyre bundle, though. You are just sort of poodling around over there. Did you just take both hands off the wheel to cheer while driving towards a chicane? No wonder you're down the back of the field. I'm amazed you're not off the track and in the water, quite frankly. I think the leader might have gone for a cheeky another lap. Good God, everyone wants to come on the go-karts. I mean, I approve. I approve. Great. I think there's only what, 12 carts at maximum going around at one time, so only 12 people can go on at once. And it's a relatively long, you know, two laps around here is a relatively long amount of time. So, wow. I'm glad that the go-karts are so popular. We'll have to fiddle about with a queue, I think. Can we? Okay, we'll let everybody get off. We'll let everybody get off the go-karts, and then we'll go have a ride. First person ride. Oh, the go-kart's got lights. Oh, we've got to have a look at this in... Okay, we're going to set the lighting to nighttime. Now, of course, everything else around here isn't lit up properly. Most of the rest of the main island is. Oh, Fort Carlton's broken down as well. My roller coasters are not having a good day, it seems. Yeah. 3 of them have broken down in the time it has taken me to build a go-kart track. Okay, come on, let the next people on. We're going to ride camera. Now, what cart do we want to be in? 1, 2, 3, or 4, or 5, or 6. I'm going to go with the blue cars. Where is it? Blue car was in 4th? The blue carts were quick last time, so I'm thinking we're going to stand a chance. It would be absolutely amazing if we got to drive the carts. I don't know if there could be a mod for this. If there could be a mod to drive the go-karts around your tracks, that would be incredible. Where are we going, man? Look, there's an apex over there somewhere. It's over there. So, okay, never mind. There's a change of position for the lead. It looks like one of the yellow carts is going to go up into the lead. Oh, we're going to have a lovely cat back. No, we're not. Maybe, actually, we might still get it. We might still get it. Put both hands on the wheel, goddammit. We've still got one hand on the wheel. We're going to go around the outside into the chicane. It might work. We might get the move done. No, it's side by side we are. We are going to get the move done. The leaders have buggered off. We spent far too long pratting around here. The leaders have long since gone. This is car 5. Unfortunately, it's not going to now be in the order that they're in, so it's going to be quite difficult to jump around. We're going to go up the inside through the helix. Good overtake. The green is not faring too well whatsoever. Yeah, car 3 is dropping back. Car 2 is in the lead. Car 1 is relatively close behind, in fact. Let's jump a little bit further back. Who else have we got in the action? We're going side by side through some more chicanes. The yellow's pretty much stopped. Well, that's not quite so great over there. Oh, there's a bit of a battle going on for whatever position this one might be. I don't know, I've lost track now. I'm enjoying go-karts. I thought I would enjoy go-karts, let's face it. You can't go wrong with go-karts in a theme park game. Is this the battle now for... No, car 8's all the way at the back. This is still the battle up there for the lead. This is the battle for the lower position. I think we actually might have all 12 karts going around at once. We've got some potential overtaking going on from green. I'm going to leave the... It's so difficult to follow what the bloody hell is happening when you're on board. Oh, we've got a potential overtake for the lead between the red and yellow car. The red car got itself back into the lead, so I'm pretty sure the yellow was leading at one point. It's not going to matter, though. Oh, unless the yellow car gets a mega run out of that final corner, it is not going to matter at all, as red is going to take victory from yellow, I think. Now, will everybody else... Now slow down, yeah. Everybody else will now slow down and go into position. The victors get to go for another lap. Red car coming home in third place. They did well. they did well indeed. The blue car, that was, I think, the car we were riding on board with. Yeah, it was indeed full to fourth place. Very close finish back here between the rest of the field. And it will be a blue car towards the back. Yellow vehicle over there. There's another yellow Hornet much, much further back. The two leaders are... still enjoying their extra lap. Well, the yellow cars did a little bit better. The yellow and green cars are actually very, very similar in colour when it's at night. Wherever the green cars... There they are, I think. Yeah, kind of a yellowy-greeny colour. Not the best distinction between them, but never mind. Should have proper British Racing green, let's face it. And there is our two victors eventually coming around. So yeah, if you're at the front of the grid, you get to have an extra lap. That's a little bit cheeky. Has anyone fixed my... roller coaster? No, they haven't. Bloody typical. Well, it does seem like you want to be at the front of the grid. It does seem to be one or two. I mean, sure, being at the front of the grid is always helpful, but we haven't seen a huge amount of vehicles make their way up through the order. I guess the blue car in that first race did quite well. I quite like that, you know, they will make mistakes, they will spin out around the track. That's quite fun. I don't know whether they'll actually, like, crash into walls and get stuck or anything like that. Could be quite entertaining if they do. The actual racing is not too shabby. You know, there are some many questionable driving racing lines going on from the... from the go-karts, but, you know, they do actually battle with each other. They do actually kind of overtake, and, yeah... I'm very impressed. I'm very impressed with the go-kart tracks. As far as the circuit goes, I'm not too displeased with this one. We've got a standout exciting corner in which someone has already, like the first race, someone managed to spin out down there. The chicanes don't quite work as well as I'd hope. Well, I mean, they say they don't work as well as they hope. Look, you can quite clearly see it's very easy to straight line. You could do them being a little bit more on the extreme side. Oh, are we going to go 2x2 up the hill? Actually got a yellow car leading and a green car in second, blue and red. You are slacking back there. You are slacking indeed. Maybe the Renaults will come good. Who's raced? Oh, it's the green. Who's raced in green? Jaguar? Probably like the only team that's ever raced in green, quite frankly. The two Ferraris are battling over third place at the moment. And there's some little bit of traffic jam through the chicane. There's another blue car going around the outside. Is the red car going to... Yep, round up the yellow vehicle on the outside. Well done. Yeah, if you haven't played Planet Coaster for a little while, there is new stuff to have a play with. I love go-karts. The racing roller coasters do look like quite good fun. There is some various bits and pieces of scenery as well. The Jaguar is streaking away at the front from the Williams, the Ferrari in third. The Renault has fallen down to fourth place. There is another Williams over there in fifth ahead of a Ferrari. There's three Ferraris. I'm thinking the shenanigans are going on. There are three Ferraris and... three Jaguars, three Williams, I think, are the only ones with three. So there's only going to be two. Unless I might be miscounting. But anyway, regardless, I'm distracted. We're going to look at scenery bits. Yes, that was what I was going to briefly show off. I don't know whether they're going to have a category for it, a scenery theme. Would it be... No, Windmill's Fairy Tale, sorry. Would it be under Planet Coaster? Okay, yeah, so it would be. So we've got various bits. So if you want to make your racetrack look nice and pretty, and want to actually go, which I might at some point have a go with, we've got various signs that you can put around the place. I'm just trying to have a look for all of the things rather than just searching sign. There is, I have seen a tyre bundle around. Oh, big old arrow. I think you can actually put some of these signposts. Yeah, so you can put text on these ones, so if you want to build up, like, you know, your little entrance bit, you can have the sign up there to name the ride, whatever you want to call it. What else have we got? There's some different ones, some smaller signposts going on over there. Road pole. Are there any, like, curbing or anything like that? I feel like there perhaps should be. Doesn't look like it. Could be in a different category. Trophy, if you want. It might be, I guess it could be under building. We could see some potential bits and pieces. Quick, I'm just doing a very quick browser's going to have a crap ton of signs, really, isn't it? You'd expect the signs, perhaps, for the racing stuff to end up in here. Doesn't look like there's a huge amount. There we go, we've got a race flag. And that's about it. That's where I saw. I guess you could. I mean, technically speaking, you could make up some curbing out of the very. Because you've got all of the little building blocks to work with. So let's use this as an example, as a tidy one. You can get a square one of those and you could build up like a red and white curb if you wanted to put it around the place. There was tyres as well. There we go. So you have a stack of tyres. You put that around. And so on and so forth. So you can actually now start making a little bit more race themed stuff. And that, again, that's always a good thing. Always a good thing, more race-themed stuff. That, though, is going to be it from me. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, goodbye.